private company. So again, you remember the meaning of company. So now we need to understand what is meaning of private. Okay, so let's check out the meaning. What it is saying here, a private limited company is a type of business entity in private ownership. Means what happens, private company, that suppose you and some of your friends decided to run a business and you created a company. Okay, so that is private company, because a few people have the exclusive right over the company. Okay, so that is a private company. However, check out its characteristic, then the meaning will be much transparent and you can appreciate them. So that is characteristics and features, both are the same term. Number of members. Okay, so number of members in a private company is limited. Okay, but in a joint stock company, that is unlimited. There is no fixed. In the private company, see, limited liability. Here is also the liability is limited up to that extent as much you invested. Perpetual succession. See, there we have studied perpetual existence. Here we are seeing perpetual succession. It means if one shareholder, one person dies, then his or her successor, son, daughter, may take over. Okay, so that is perpetual succession. Index of members. Okay, so members, the number of members, the index of members, that is again need to be incorporated. Numbers of directors. So certain number of directors are essentially required of a private company. Prospectus. Prospectus, it is a document that contains all the information about the company, the board of directors, the businesses and everything. The next point is minimum subscriptions. So it required certain number of subscriptions. Without that, you cannot form the private company. But when we will discuss the difference between private company and public company, you will understand certain points that you might not able to appreciate at this point in time. So don't worry. Rest of the things, I believe we are repeating, so it is easy to appreciate. The next one is the examples of private company. So what are the company like Flipkart, Book My Show? So there are a number of companies you can name that is a private company. Now we have the again some additional information regarding the private company types. So see, what are the types of private company? Limited by shares. So in private company, limited by shares. So how much share you hold in a company, accordingly it is categorized. The next one is limited by guarantee. Okay, the next one is unlimited liability. Now the next one is formation through registration by fulfilling the legal requirements. So of course, under the law, there are certain provisions and procedures that you need to follow to form a private company, and it is comparatively very easy to form. Okay, next one is advantages. What are the advantages? Let's check out. Only minimum two directors are required. So to run a private company, only two persons are required. Two persons can form a company. No need to prepare a report for annual general meetings. So for a private company, it is not essentially required to prepare annual general meetings. Okay, but for a larger company, public company, it is essentially required to do that. Now come to the next topic, that is limitation. What is limitation? Cannot transfer share freely. Well, of course, if you and your friend formed a company and you want to transfer your share, as we have studied, in a joint stock company, here you cannot do that. Shareholders have greater risks and liabilities. Here, since you are supposed to be having the greater shares, greater investments, and there are limited people, so of course the risks and liabilities, that is also greater. Okay, Now come to the next topic that we have, that is public companies.